In this video, we'll cover the steps I took to replace a trunk release cable on a 2004 Camry. If you ever hop in your car and pull on this lever here, and your trunk doesn't open, you've got a problem. The most probable cause is this cable is snapped off on the lever. I called around, and the average price to repair is $500 to $600 at a shop. For that much money, I think it's time for me to learn a new skill, and I'll take you along with me on my journey. There's a cut in the carpet underneath the lever. Pull it back and you'll see a bolt. The bolt is 10 millimeters and is the only one holding this lever in place. But don't waste your time pulling it off with a wrench like I did. You're going to have to pull back this portion of the carpet anyway, so pull the carpet back first, then use a socket later. Okay, to pull the carpet away from this lever, start out by popping off the door trim. It's just held in with some friction fittings, so just give it a nice yank. Pop the wire bundle out of this clip. Now we need to pry this clip off. It's holding the carpet down. It's also a pop-off, but you really need to pry at it to get it to come out. This is what it looks like, and it'll snap right back in place. Now you want to remove the front two bolts holding down the driver's seat. They're 14 millimeter. This will allow us to lean the driver's seat back just a little bit to get the carpet loose. Go ahead and lean that seat back, then pull the carpet. You now have easy open access to work on the lever. 10 millimeter socket takes care of it. Gently pull the lever forward. There'll be a little resistance when you're pulling on it, but the two cables attached to it are plenty long enough for you to pull the lever out where you can actually work on it. Okay, here we see the broken end of the cable. It was attached here, and it should have gone into that hole. Problem confirmed. Let's gain access to the rest of the cable. Start by popping off the door trim on the back seat. It too is held in by friction. Back here, the wire bundle is held in by a pan to it. You can either cut it, or you can give it a little bit of a tug. It comes off pretty easily. But the wire bundle does have to come off in order to get the carpet loose. Underneath the carpet along the door, you can see the two cables. One for the door release on your gas filler, and the trunk release cable. The big one's a wire bundle. We're not going to mess with that. After running along the door, it runs next to the back seat, then up this side wall here. To gain access, we need to remove this side cushion. It's held in by one 12 millimeter bolt. It's very easily removed with a very long extension on your ratchet. Now this part's really important. Push upward on the cushion. If you pull it forward or wiggle it too much, you run the risk of breaking it. The part you would be breaking is this plastic clip that holds the top of the cushion in place. So as you can see, you have to go up about an inch, inch and a half, that clip to clear. The bolt you pulled out went into this hole in the bottom of the cushion. We now have easy access to the cable. You can see it running up the sidewall. And then it goes through this little hole into the trunk. We'll want to remove the trunk lid liner. It's held in place by these little buttons. As a matter of fact, it's held in place by a lot of little buttons. Before starting on the buttons, remove the manual trunk release handle. The cover pops off with a screwdriver placed into the front of it, then gently pry the base off. It will all snap back in place later. You can use the same screwdriver to pry the middle part of the button out. Once it comes out about a quarter inch, the button should come out, or fall out. When you remove the last button, the whole liner is now free to be removed. The last disassembly we have to do is the driver's side sidewall in the trunk. We just have to remove this one fastener. It does pop out, but you gotta really work at it to get it out. Now the sidewall has enough flexibility for you to work in there. You're all done removing everything except the cable, which runs from the latch, across the door, down the trunk lid arm, through a large hole, and along the door frame. Now that we've gained access to the entire run of the cable, let's put the new one in. This is what a new Toyota cable looks like, and the part number. You can put this in backwards, so let's pay attention here. The cable end with the rectangular fitting goes forward, and the end with the round ball stays back in the trunk and hooks up to the latch. I started my cable routing from the trunk, pulled the sidewall back enough to look inside, and you can see the old cable routing. Just start routing your new cable through the same hole the old cable is coming out of. It'll pop out right next to the back seat. Go down that sidewall to the floorboard of the back seat. It's a very straightforward and easy routing through here, and there's only one plastic clip holding all this in place. Now, routing it from the back seat to the front seat, a little more tricky. What I did in the front seat was tied a string to the broken cable. Then I pulled on the cable. This showed me which cable in the back seat I need to pull on. Now, from the back seat, pull the bad cable out until you get your string. Remove the string from the bad cable and tie it off to the new good cable. Now move back up to the front seat and start gently pulling on the string. You'll pull the new good cable all the way underneath that carpet and it'll pop right out. As far as I can tell, the carpet's the only thing holding the cable in place. If you're having any trouble pulling it through, pull off this piece of trim off of the back of the driver's seat and use a 14mm socket or wrench to remove the bolt. That should allow the carpet to flex enough to let the cable pass. Don't forget to put this bolt back in after you pulled the cable through. Hook up the cable to the release lever. Unfortunately, my photography skills failed at this point, so I'll give you some assisting pictures. This is the cable next to the release lever. The square metal end fits into this hole here, and this rubber grommet fits into this slot right here. You can now rebolt the release lever into place. Let's finish up in the trunk. Cable comes out of the hole that you fed it through, through these clips on the trunk arm, this clip at the top of the trunk arm, this clip here, into this hole, and it pops out of this opening. Plenty of room to reach your hand in to grab it. The cable rubber grommet fits into this slot on the trunk latch, and the round metal ball slips through a little slot and locks into place on the latch. There are no tools required for any of this stuff back here. Just unclip the old cable and clip the new one into place. This ought to show you how easy it is to remove and hook back up again. First, I'm removing it. Now, I'll hook it back up again. Head back up to the front of the car and pull on the lever, and this is what you get. It works. Now it's time to put the car back together. If you haven't already done it, remount your release lever with one bolt. Reinstall all the mounting bolts for the front seat. That would be the two in the front and possibly one in the back. Snap your wire bundle clip back into place. Put your wire bundle into it, then reinstall your door trim. In the back seat, if your carpet got pulled out of the side pillar trim, you should be able to just push it back underneath the trim. Reattach the panduit holding down your wire bundle. If it broke when you were removing it, I'll show you a kit at the end of the video where you can replace it with. Then pop your door trim back into place. We can now reinstall the back seat side cushion. Line up that plastic tab at the top of the cushion into the slot it belongs in and then pull straight down on it. Reinstall the single bolt at the bottom of the seat. Finally, we can move into the trunk. You should have a whole bunch of button clips like the one on top and one Christmas tree clip like the one on the bottom. That bottom Christmas tree clip goes into the sidewall. Now let's talk about this button clip. There's three pretty fragile pieces of plastic on this thing. And they do break off pretty easily, like this one's missing two of them. If any of those plastic pieces are missing, this clip will not work and it has to be replaced. You can usually buy little packages of five or so of these at the auto parts store, but they're pretty spendy. Or better yet, plan ahead and buy a bulk kit off the internet. When you buy in this quantity, they're considerably cheaper. And this kit came with removal tools, as well as replacement panduits that you may have broken in the back seat. It's time to put the last piece on. Inside liner for the trunk lid. Lift it up and put the button in the very center. That will hold it in place. Now it's easy to go around and replace all the missing clips. Basically, if there's a hole, put a clip in it. Oh, let's not forget the emergency handle. Just snap it into place. Congratulations, you just saved $500 to $600, less parts. And hopefully you've got a big bucket of extra clips for your next repair job. Well, thanks for watching.